Yes.
Hi, my name is Mike Hutchins-Lopez. I'm the captain of the Kalamazoo Dance Team, part of class of 2022. This is going to be a behind-the-scenes look at what it's like to be a member on the Kalamazoo Dance Team. So at the beginning of the year, we are at K-Fest, and K-Fest is kind of this big thing where student organizations come and they tell incoming freshmen and sophomores about what it's like to be in certain student organizations. And so the Kalamazoo Dance Team goes to the K-Fest and sets up a booth and recruits people to come to tryouts. A couple days pass, and then we have tryouts for individuals who want to be on the dance team. And there's just a song from past years that we pick, and we just teach them the dances. And then we get to pick individuals to be on the team from that audition or tryout. Once the team is picked, then we move on to starting practices. And practices look pretty much the same for each season that we have. But basically we meet twice a week, sometimes three times. And we meet for 1 hour or 1.5 hours, depending on how much there's to learn for that certain performance. And then we learn a new song or a new part of the song, depending on how long the song is at each practice. So for clothing, we have multiple different outfits depending on the games and the seasons. Something that stays consistent is that we have black and white shoes. And then when we're doing football season, when it's cold outside, we let them wear certain socks. Every member has some version of some Kalamazoo socks that we get as incoming freshmen. And then you are allowed to wear a black or a white hat to dance on the field when it's a little bit colder outside. So for football, we have a dress that we've had for years, ever since I was a freshman. And we just wear that when it's a little bit colder outside. We put leggings on underneath it and kind of bundle up a little bit better. But the dress is pretty warm inside when you dance in it, so we have that as our top half, at least for football season. In the winter for basketball, we used to in past years wear all black. We would have specialized jackets that say Kalamazoo Dance Team on it, and then we'd wear black leggings and black top underneath it. But for this year, we had something new. We actually got these tank tops that are kind of higher neckline and crop tops, and they say KDT on it like my sweatshirt does. And then we also got leggings that have the same logo on the top part of the band of the high-waisted leggings. And then for the basketball games, in the past, also, we've had themes, so we've worn red, we've worn all black with purple and yellow to kind of honor Kobe Bryant and his daughter passing, and we've just been able to have a little bit more fun with basketball. Basketball's a little bit more calm and relaxed, and it's in person, so the uniforms, the outfits can be seen a little bit more in more detail, and so this past year, we were able to wear bandanas, and we were able to wear flannels or jean shirts on top of them, just to add a little bit of something different on top of a pretty uniform underneath outfit. So during performance week, like I said, we usually have 2 to 3 practices. We actually have an extra practice every single Friday for performance weeks, and that's just a practice to finalize things, make sure we're on the same page, make sure positions are clean, and that like all the little things are fully set in motion. So we kind of split up into 2 or 3 groups, and we go through each routine, especially if there's like a sides part of it. There's some dances where one side is doing something different than the other side, or one group is doing something different than the other group, and so we just run through it a bunch of times and make sure that it looks good. And then on performance day, we meet 1 or 2 hours before the game starts, and we practice and we get ready together sometimes, and we go through positions on the field or on the court, because we're not usually allowed to be inside of the basketball court or on the field during the week just because of academic restrictions or athletic restrictions. And so we go on the field and the court for spacing, and then we take pictures just beforehand just to kind of make sure that we get some and commemorate it. We take them after as well, but just before, making sure that we have some before we're maybe a little bit sweaty or just, I don't know, exhausted. And then we enjoy the game whenever it starts, because we're usually there before the game starts. So we get to kind of run through it, practice a little bit, and then enjoy the game. And then we wait for halftime, and then we go out and perform on the field of the court. Something different that we do in the year is Fralon. Fralon Dance Company is the other dance organization on campus. And basically for Fralon, which is a whole different ball game, we just go through the tech weeks. We learn something like we usually would weeks before. We have the extra Friday rehearsal. And then we go to the tech nights. And then on Fralon night, we act like we're another performance. We just go on stage and we perform. And we wear whatever we want. We don't wear necessarily the uniforms. I know we have in the past, but we don't always do that. Kind of go with the theme and whatever the song and the choreography feels like. Something else that we do is we do AFDS, which is Afro Fiesta Desi Sol. And that is just an event that happens on campus where a lot of the POC, the BIPOC organizations on campus get to showcase who they are and, you know, some of their favorite parts of their culture to the school. And so the BIPOC members of KDT perform a piece of choreography and they just show off their culture. We've danced to a Formation by Beyonce, Work by Rihanna, Poison, King's Dead, Problema, My Power, and that's just a start, and I'm sure it's gonna keep going for years to come. Yeah, and then we just kind of treat that as like another performance. We practice weeks in advance. In the past, we've kind of collaborated on choreography to make sure that we all have a part of our culture involved, because usually captains choreograph for the most part the other performances of the year. And so it's nice to have everybody's input who's a POC member or a BIPOC member of KDT get their input on the choreography that we're going to be doing. And then one more thing that we do that is really, really just special for us as a team is we take pictures every year. We have the last couple of years. So we just go to the gym or the athletic center and we just take pictures in our football outfits and our basketball outfits. And we really just create a memory as a team. And then we also get to take individual shots, headshots, class photos, and then like just group photos also on the quad, which is really, really nice because it's nice to have pictures that are different than what you're usually wearing for KDT, but also get to showcase the individual and the unique creativity that each member has, because we're all very different even though we're dancing a very similar style of dance. Yeah, it's just a nice way to create a memory with a team as one together. And there are so many other things that happen in KDT that I'm sure that I'm missing that I'm not gonna talk about, but this is just the start and this is just kind of the foundation of what it's like to be a member on the team. It's a lot of time commitment for practicing and it's a lot of just logistical things depending on who's on the team and what their schedule is. We have a lot of members from different academic backgrounds, different socioeconomic backgrounds, and they just have different skill levels. And so it's nice to come together on campus as a team and just become a family, honestly. But it's been an honor the past 4 years to be able to be a captain and to just make these memories and get to kind of pass on the torch to the next class and the next captains, the next members. And I'm excited to see how KDT's going because we're just getting started. We've only been a student organization for 7 years. And so I'm excited to see what happens after I graduate and how it gets carried along and passed on. And so I hope you've enjoyed this behind the scenes look at KDT. If there's anything else you want to know, leave it in the comments below and we will try and answer as many questions as possible about what it's like to be a member of KDT. Don't forget to follow the Kalamazoo Dance Team on Instagram and Facebook at KZU Dance Team or the Kalamazoo College Dance Team.